Hi everyone, welcome back to Treworgey. As always, thank you very much for sending in more videos of the things you've been trying at home. A clear favourite has been the stomp rocket. So, what I thought we'd do today is do rocket part two! So, what we're going to do today is to add some water into the mix to get our rocket even higher into space. Now, to build this new rocket, it's not that difficult, but there's a few specialist bits that you're going to need. So let's go through those now. First off, you're going to need your bottle. Second up, you're going to need some cardboard. Then some more tape. Your scissors. This is where it gets unusual. We're going to need a wine cork. Then we're going to need a drill with a 1.5 millimeter drill bit. We're going to need a bicycle pump, and the most important bit is an adapter that's usually used to pump up footballs and things like that. And you may possibly also need a little saw. So go and gather the things and let's get building. Now the most important thing for this rocket is that your cork fits into your bottle really tightly. So take your cork and push it in. We want it to be able to go in but be really tight, so that looks like a really good fit. You might have a cork that's a bit narrower, in which case you can use some insulation tape to make it a bit wider. So that's what I've done with this one. So just take some insulation tape and just wrap it around to make it a bit thicker. The next thing we want to do is check that the length of our cork is about the same as the length of the needle adapter for our pump. So if you find that the cork's longer than it, we'll need to trim it down so that when the needle's pushed inside the cork, the needle just comes out the other end. So this is where you need that saw, and because we're using saws, you probably want to get an adult to do this bit for you, or at least supervise. So just trim it down to suit. Next, we need to bore a hole through the middle of our cork with our drill. So again, we're using power tools here, so probably best to get an adult to do this bit for you. Now you can check the fit of your needle valve into your cork, so just poke it into the hole and gently squeeze it through, making sure that it comes out the other end. You might need to hook it up to the pump just to blow out any bits of cork that have got jammed in it. So what we've made so far is the valve that is going to be crucial in launching our rocket. So now we can move on to making the rocket, and that's really simple. You just take some cardboard, make some fins and stick them to your bottle. But crucially, you've got to make sure your fins stick out below the rocket enough that you can fit the head of your pump in there, because otherwise you won't be able to stand it up on the ground to launch it. Now, depending on how strong your cardboard is, you may want to double up your fins to make it nice and stiff, because otherwise the rocket won't stand up under its own weight on the launch pad. Now you've got your fins all cut out, just stick them onto your bottle using lots of tape. So remember, some is good, more's better. Let's go. That's all there is to it, to building the rocket. So now all we've got to do is put a bit of water in, pump it up and watch it fly. I reckon about the right amount of water is a third of the bottle. So if you fill it up to what you think's a third, and then we'll see what happens. Hopefully you've all had a successful launch and got your rockets way up into the sky. But why do they work? Well, I'll try and explain. If you imagine this glass, is your rocket. It's full of air, but you can't see that, can you? So, if we put some bits of sponge in it to represent the air, there we go. Not before you pump it up, it's just full of air like that. But as you pump it, you put more and more and more and more and more air into it. And the air that goes in squashes up like a spring. And eventually, when you've put enough air in, it builds up enough pressure to pop out the cork that we did. And when that happens, all the air shoots out the back. So why do we need the water? Well, let's have a go without any water and see what happens. So it did kind of work, but it didn't go very high. Well, how about if we fill the bottle all the way to the top with water? Then what happens? Dear oh dear, that wasn't very good, was it? So it all seems to be about getting a balance, somewhere between all the way to the top and none at all, to make it go super high. That's about all for today, guys. As always, send me in any pictures and videos of your attempts. Be creative, put bubble bath in it, try long ones, short ones, big fins, small fins. Just have a go with it. Until next time, bye.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Thunderbirds are go.